It was just 2 years ago that J.W. Walsh had the Geyer Wildcats in the state title game. Last Saturday, he was in Cowboys Stadium to cheer on the next big thing, Jerod Hurd, as he had Geyer back in the finals. It's been quite a rise for the junior, who has gone from being one of the better signal callers in the Metroplex to becoming a Texas commit and one of the best quarterback prospects in the country for 2014. His parents are proud of what he's been able to achieve at a successful program like Geyer.
It's been very exciting. We're so proud of Jerod. He's handled it very well. He comes from a family that keeps him grounded. He still have to do the things that normal kids have to do. And we're just excited about the things that he's accomplished this year.
Jerod has done an excellent job maintaining what has been established here in the Geyer as far as tradition in football. The winning is, you know, compared to none. And as far as the team itself, I think they're a great team right now, and the chemistry is awesome.
But could that chemistry topple the undefeated Georgetown Eagles in the state championship? Hurd and the Geyer offense came out clicking as he hit Ellis Jefferson for an early 31-yard score to go up 7-0. But Geyer was having trouble getting stops on defense. Georgetown running back Austin Weston gave them trouble in the first half. Here he breaks off a 56-yard touchdown run, the second of his two scores on the day to tie the game at 14. Later in the second, quarterback Jake Hubenick hits Randy Neider, gives the Eagles a 20-14 lead. They were up 9 at halftime. And the Hubenick-Neider connection worked again early in the third. This touchdown made it 30-14 Georgetown, and things were looking bleak for Geyer. But earlier in the week, Coach Walsh talked about momentum after his team nearly let their semifinal game against John Tyler slip away. He said his team came in understanding that a team can rally and quickly turn a game around.
We always try to express the momentum of football, how critical it is. And when they gained momentum, then they gained some more of it. And before you know it, they had it all. And then we had to find a way to get it back. And I think our kids understand now that the team that ends the game with the momentum on their side is going to win.
For the rest of the game, that's exactly what Geyer did. First, Hurd breaks off this 17-yard touchdown run to cut the lead to 10. Then after the defense got a fourth down stop, Hurd marched the team down the field again, capped off this drive with a 14-yard touchdown, and suddenly, it's a three-point game. Then the key play of the game, Georgetown deep at its own end. Hubenick is pressured, sacked by Connor Allen. The ball pops out, DeMondre Taylor falls on it, and Geyer takes over at the 5-yard line. That's when the Wildcats knew they were in control.
After Connor made that big play, and then when he saw the ball come out, it was just like we knew we had the momentum going in, and we were right there, you know, close to the goal line. So, you know, I knew our offense was going to score.
Hurd's subsequent touchdown gave Geyer a 34-30 lead and even got J.W. Walsh fired up. The defense kept coming up big. Georgetown threatened early in the fourth quarter, but Will Sanders comes up with the big interception near the goal line, and Geyer fans were starting to smell that championship. And they could really feel it a couple of plays later. Hurd goes up top to Ellis Jefferson. Jefferson hauls it in and takes it to the house. A 71-yard backbreaking touchdown. Jefferson, listen to these stats, 176 yards, two scores on the day. Geyer goes on to claim the state championship, 48-37 the final, and to no one's surprise, Hurd gets the offensive MVP with 5 rushing touchdowns and 2 more passing. For Geyer, it was a great sense of relief and accomplishment after breaking through as state champions.
I'm excited for all of Dittenger. We've been close for the last 5 years, and to finally get it done is refreshing is what it is. You know, we knew we were good enough, and we've been good enough a couple years in the past and just didn't finish it. So to finally finish it is very refreshing.
I also thought about my mom. She really pushed that at home, get that ring, and she told me if, you know, I get that ring, I could do a lot over this break, so.
Tina's pretty strict.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
You meet my mom. She's a pretty strict lady. She keeps my head straight, so it's going to be relaxed, and, you know, I'm going to have a great time over this break.